Today, we are talking about school. Let's do some books about pencils before the storm. Chapter 1. All kinds of pencils. People use pencils every day. Little kids who are just learning to write use big, fat pencils. Small, stubby pencils are used at golf courses and libraries. Artists often use colored pencils. Have you used a pencil today? Have you ever thought about how pencils are made? There are many steps. Take a look at the pencil right now. Look at all the different materials in your pencil. How many do you see? There should be at least 3. The part that writes, the wood around it, and the eraser. The first step to making a pencil starts in a forest. That is where the wood comes from. Chapter 2. In the forest. Most pencils are made from incense cedar trees. The wood from these trees is perfect for pencils. It does not break easily, but it is soft enough to sharpen. It also does not split or shrink in hot or humid weather. Many people like the smell of cedar wood. Can you imagine the smell of the newly sharpened pencil? Incense cedar trees grow in central and northern California and the southern part of Oregon. These trees are grown in sustainable forests. Foresters are workers who manage the forests. They plan when trees are cut down and make sure their new trees are planted. That way there will always be new trees growing. Incense cedar trees are cut down using chainsaws or large machines. The trees are loaded onto trucks and taken to sawmills. About 300,000 pencils can be made from one large incense cedar tree. Chapter 3. The sawmill. At the sawmill, sawing machines are used. These machines cut logs into pencil stock. Pencil stock are long blocks of wood that are all cut to the same size. When they are made into pencils, very little wood is wasted. The pencil stock is dried in a special kiln or oven. It removes moisture from the wood. Now the pencil stock is ready to be loaded onto trucks or trains to travel to the slat factory. Chapter 4. The Slat Factory. At the slat factory, the pencil stock is cut into smaller blocks. They are called pencil blocks. The pencil blocks are 8 inches long. Next, a circular saw is used. It cuts each block into several very thin pieces called pencil slats. The slats are treated with stang and wax. This makes the wood all the same color. It also makes the wood easier to work with and sharpen. Now the slats can be shipped to pencil factory. Often the slats travel by truck or train. If the pencil factory is on another continent, the slats may be loaded onto ships. Slats that came from trees in California may be shipped all the way to China or Germany to be made into pencils. Chapter 5. At the pencil factory. The outside of the pencil is important, but the inside is even more important. The inside is a part that does the writing. It is called the lead, but it is not made from lead. The inside of the pencil is made from the soft mineral called graphite. At the pencil factory, powdered graphite is mixed with clay and water to make a soft paste. The paste is pushed through narrow tubes. This forms it into thin, spaghetti-like rods. The rods are cut into pencil-length pieces. Then they are baked in a very hot oven. The heat makes the graphite hard and smooth. Now the leads are ready to be put into pencils. There are still some work to be done before pencil leads can be put into pencils. When the wood slats get to the factory, they are run under the giant cutting wheel. The wheel cuts 6 to 9 shallow grooves into each slat. The grooves are filled with glue by another machine. Next, a third machine places leads in the slat. A second slat is coated with glue and laid on top of the first slat. This is done with a machine called the lead layer. This makes a kind of sandwich with the two groove slats and the leads in the middle. Finally, the slats are put between two clamps. The clamps press the slats together while the glue dries. A shaping machine cuts each slat 2 times. These cuts shape and sever the pencils. The first cut is on the top of the slat. It makes half of the hexagon shape of the pencil. The second cut is made of the bottom slat. It forms the other half of the hexagon. When that second cut is made, the slat separates into individual pencils. Not all pencils are hexagons. Some pencils have round sides. Now the pencils are checked for quality. The lead may not be the center of the pencil, or the wood may be chipped. A worker sharpens one pencil from each batch by hand. This tests the quality of the lead. Then the tip is tested for strength. The pencil is held in the clamp while the plunger presses on the tip until it breaks. A machine measures how much pressure the tip can be take before it breaks. If it breaks too soon, the pencil is not sold. The next step is to paint the pencils. Most pencils in the United States are painted yellow. Sometimes black, red, or even hot pink paints are used. To paint the pencils quickly and effectively, workers run the pencils through the machine. It coats the pencil in paint. A pencil needs at least 4 coats of paint. Some pencils are coated with paint up to 8 times. A final clear coat of liquia is added at the end. It seals the paint and makes the pencils tough and shiny. Next, a machine stamps each pencil. It marks the name of the company that produced it, and it marks a number that tells how hard the lead is. You probably use a number 2 pencil for most of your schoolwork. Artists often use soft leads. You may have also noticed the letters HB on your pencil. HB stands for hard black. It tells you that the lead inside the pencil is hard and black. Most pencils have erasers at the top. The eraser may be made at the same factory that makes the pencil. It may also be shipped from the factory that only makes the erasers. Pencil erasers are called plugs. Plugs can be made for rubber or vinyl. To make the plugs, the raw ingredients are mixed together and heated. In addition to rubber or vinyl, plugs may contain vegetable oil, sulfur, pumice, coloring, and other chemicals. Then the mixture is forced through the small hole in a machine called the extruder. The mixture comes out a hole in a long, thin strand. The strands are cut into 3-foot pieces. If the strands are made for rubber, they must be heated for the rubber to cure. Vinyl does not need to be cured. Next, a machine cuts the strands into tiny plugs. Thousands of plugs are dumped into a giant drum machine. It spins slowly for several hours. As the plugs tumble against each other, the edges rub together and become rounded. Now the eraser can be attached to the rest of the pencil. There are several steps. A machine is used to do this job. Can you see the band of metal on the pencil? That metal band is called a ferrule. It holds the eraser in place. The pencils move down a conveyor belt to a different parts of the machine. Each part has its own job to do. The first part of the machine squeezes or cuts the edges of the top of the pencil. This makes it smaller than the rest of the pencil. Then a plunger slides the ferrule over that end of the pencil. Some pencil factories use glue to keep the ferrule in place. If glue is not used, the ferrule is squeezed onto the pencil. Next, the machine places a eraser into the open end of the ferrule. If glue has been used, a plunger pushes the plug into place. If glue has not been used, the machine crunches the ferrule. This keeps the eraser from falling out. With the eraser in place, the pencil is finished. However, some pencils are sold already sharpened. These pencils are sharpened using a grinding drum. The pencils are rolled across the drum and the angle. This makes the tips touch the drum. When the pencils reach the end of the drum, the pencils have perfect points. Now the pencils are ready to be put into boxes. Machines put just the right number of pencils in each box and seal it. The boxes are put into larger boxes and loaded over trucks. They are taken to warehouses until it's time for them to ship our stores. Chapter 6. Enter your hand. You can buy pencils at office supply stores, supermarkets, and variety stores. You may even be able to buy them at your school. Most pencils came in boxes, but sometimes special pencils are sold individually. Have you ever bought a pencil with a purple star eraser, or do you have without school's name on it? These extras do not come from a pencil factory. Another company adds them later. You need pencils for tests and schoolwork, or maybe you like to sketch with them. Having a pencil is always a good thing. Just remember to bring your sharpener, too. In the forest, at the sawmill, the slat factory, pencil lead made, lead put into slats, erasers added, into boxes at the store. The end.